Kwaelo, whose trial commenced in September 2018, has been in custody at Luzira Maximum Prison since 2009, after he was captured by the Ugandan army in the Democratic Republic of Congo in March the same year. While appearing before the division court chaired by Honorable Justice Michael Elubu that sat at Gulu High Court for ruling on the matter that has been before the court for over 10 years, he was acquitted of 15 counts. Among the counts acquitted include rape, crime against humanity, murder, among others.
The accused has not yet to answer and is hereby acquitted of those counts. E, with the exception of count 46, which is a repetition of count 45, the accused has yet to answer in respect of the remaining 78 counts.
The counts were acquitted on grounds that the evidence produced by the prosecutor is not enough to pin him to these counts and that one was repeated.
We need to understand that Kwaelo had been charged with about 93 counts actually. In these 93 counts, after hearing over 70 or 80 witnesses, the court has only found that he has a case to answer in respect of 78. So as a defense, it's a reduced burden for him, and we believe that he will be able to explain himself.
Jacqueline Okui, the public relations officer in the office of the DPP, explained why some of the charges were dropped.
And this was because a number of our witnesses died, some of them relocated. You know, at the time that this case was investigated, most of the victims or witnesses were in IDP camps. So by the time the case came up for trial, these victims and witnesses had relocated. So it became very difficult to get them.
The court has adjourned the hearing of the case to 19th January for further mention. Kwaelo is the first among the top LRA commanders to face a domestic court on crimes related to sexual violence, murder, kidnap, robbery, among others, allegedly committed between 1993 and 2005 in Pabo Lamoji sub-county in present-day Amuru district. Meanwhile, lawyers to Patricia Kankwanza, who faces trial in connection to the murder of her father, Henry Katanga, have complained about the constant change of prosecutors in this matter. According to Mark Dusman Kabega, the defense lawyer to the accused persons, the change of prosecutors is aimed at delaying the trial, which is an injustice to the suspects. The three suspects include the late Henry Katanga's daughter, Kankwanza Patricia, George Amanyire, and Charles Otai, and these had returned to Nakawa Chief Magistrate Court for the mention of their case. During court, Samali Wakoli, who represented the state, informed court that she had just received the case file and had not perused through it. She asked for an adjournment. This angered the defense team, who accused prosecution of deliberately delaying the trial.
So, as a state, we are not in a position to handle any bail application this morning.
I don't know who is charged with what. We are even ready now to bring them all the documents.
So, Your Worship, it seems like this is the new trend that we are having. Every time we come to court, we have a new officer. We all claim they are just looking at the file. And on that basis, they ask for adjournment.
Consequently, Presiding Chief Magistrate Arias Kakosa adjourned the matter to the 8th of January 2024. The hearing of Kankwanza's bail application is also still pending. 31-year-old Patricia Kankwanza is charged with destroying evidence alongside 30-year-old George Amanyire, a shamba boy, at Katanga's home, and Charles Otai, a health worker, both charged with accessory after the fact of murder. Prosecution alleges that Henry Katanga was shot dead on November 2nd, 2023 at Mbuya Chwatu Road, Nakawa Division in Kampala, by his 55-year-old wife, Molly Katanga. Prosecution further states that Amanyire George and Charles Otai, a nursing officer at Chireka B Cell in Wakiso District, received or assisted other people known to them to be liable for an offense in order to enable them escape punishment. Still in court, Nakawa Chief Magistrate Court has adjourned the matter of a case in which Abdul Rashid Choto alias Njovu is charged with attacking and killing a tourist couple in Queen Elizabeth National Park. The presiding Chief Magistrate Arias Kakoza adjourned the matter to 8th January, pending completion of investigations. Njovu, a member of the ADF rebel group, faces 3 counts of murder, 2 counts of terrorism, 3 counts of aggravated robbery, and 1 count of belonging to a terrorist group. The charges are in respect to an attack in Queen Elizabeth National Park, where 2 foreign tourists, Balo David Jemus and Gaya Cecilia, and their Ugandan driver, Eric Alai, were shot dead and their vehicle set ablaze by terrorists. Rachel Nachwala and Dennis Oti for the news.